Alright, howdy all, my name is Christian Ferro. This is my first commentary ever on this channel, like over a little thing for a video. I always went out fishing yesterday, at the Champion Lake. Yeah, it's been like a year and a half since I've been there. It's been a long time since I've been at this lake, and it just felt good to be back there. Nothing spoiled anything, but you know, it feels really, really good to be back. Because I've gotten really, really good memories here. Like, here's continuing to the wacky form. That's about details of that later in the video. But, you know, this brings back really, really good memories. Because this is the first lake I've gotten ever. First bass ever. It was really, really fun. I've gotten deep. I caught some amount of good bass at this lake. Really, really cool. I like this lake a lot. This is kind of making me emotional right now, because it brings back tons of memories from when I was about 7, 8 years old. I started fishing this like in roughly 3rd grade, so that was like 4 years ago, so I was roughly 7 when I started fishing this lake. There's a lot of memories there that brings back. Until I saw her face. It's really cool, like, Southern California, I believe it is. I love a lot. But most of this, footage you see here is just me with my GoPro sitting down on a rock or a post or something like here, like right here, right now. Sitting on a rock. But because I don't have a tripod yet, which I'm getting done soon, so you'll actually get better angles and stuff with the tripod. Also get a head down, chest down, so you guys can get a different angle. Also, like a first person. Look at all the GoPro and stuff, but you can talk to you. It's wacky when I'm in a kind of a scum filled area. It's kind of rough, and you can see there's a lot of like weeds in there, so. I'm gonna switch like right after this little focus like right now and switch back and switch. You guys can see it right now. I'm fishing like on a little, like I'm just fishing with a Zoom Super Fluke. Now those baits, just using a little post. I'm using it right now. From the post, so I just have to put it down on the board. But I haven't really been at this lake, so I'm still kind of roughly finding out good places, because it's been, forever since I've been there. So, yeah. I'm just here and now commentating a lot. But, you know, I'm kind of going with the front for a more kind of finesse kind of retrieve during these small footages, because, you know, it's been a while. I'm going to slow down and see if there's any really good places to fish at. Like what the good places are to fish, and you know, look at a lot. So I'm just trying to slow down, see target main like points, ridges, humps, stumps, weed beds and stuff like that. But I think I'm gonna change different area right now. But you know, just enjoy this right now. I'll come back with commentary later. This crazy world made more sense to me. So here's just a little quick underwater footage. Oh, that's my flip right there. I didn't know it's my flip. Oh, never mind. That's Twitch. So it's Sony. So where I'm fishing right now actually is right, literally right next to a little dock. Seen a giant 4.5-5 pounder there a few years ago, so I decided why not fish there and see if I can get that 5 pounder again. Apparently wasn't there. Been fishing all over the place. I've been fishing for 45 minutes, 1 hour, like the time I recorded this. Yeah, just trying to see if I can get like bit underneath the dock. Fish around the post of the dock and see if I can pull out anything there. It's really, really cool, you know, just being on that lake and smelling the trees, being out pretty much almost in the middle of nowhere, just like smelling those pine trees, smelling the water, just, you know, that kind of like nature, yucky nature smell brings back a lot of memories. Yeah, I've been out in nature a lot. Okay. But, you know, I'm just switching out baits to Magnum Flipping 2 from Bass Pro. Baits are really cool, so I'm just gonna flip those around docks and stuff. Tubes are great baits, by the way. You can imitate a lot of things. You can imitate crayfish, bluegill, shad, trench lines, and all that. But, you know, it's really, really cool. A lot of those baits, you can try it out. Those have really, really great action in them. I'll get back to you with a little commentary after I'm a good spot. Back to the pew, preach around a choir, singing about God and brimstone and fire, and the smell of Sunday chicken after church. And I go back to the loss of a real good friend and the 16 summers I shared with him. Now only the good die young stops me in my tracks. Okay, so the things I really like to do with these tubes is kind of fish them kind of erratically, in a slowish kind of way. So, you know, in a kink, it's kind of like an injured fish, bait fish, because the way I do it, it looks like a bait fish, so I kind of like to fish it slow with my feet. So I just like to kind of fish it erratically, so it kind of looks like a kind of injured bait fish trying to get away, trigger out fish. But, you know, I didn't really catch any fish today. I mean, that day that I recorded this, the reason is, you know, it's been a long time since I've been there. I did see one kid pull out nice, probably 1 pound bass there, but the only fish I've seen there. But, you know, I'm still trying to get used to that lake because I'm so used to fishing the other lake. But anyway, this has just been kind of a short commentary, and I got my tube stuck up in a tree, so. Got my tube stuck up in the tree, and it's kind of weird. I'm trying to get it undone. Dirt face. But anyway, see ya. Hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know if you want to do any more of this commentary stuff, like this, what I'm doing right now, because I really enjoyed it, making this video, and trimming vids. But if you haven't done it already, please hit the subscribe button below to join us today, and see you on the next video, and brohoof. All of my love, my hugs, my kisses.